Rahmanir Rahim. We are here now with a great opportunity to show you viewers at home, dear viewers, what the campsite of Imam Al-Hussein looks like. We are here now inside the encampment, and every corner of this place, every corner that we are in, has one of the tents of the family of Imam Al-Hussein, peace be upon him. For example, in here you have the tent of Sayyida Zainab. Inside in that corner you have the tent of Qasim, son of Imam Al-Hassan. You have the tent of Ali Al-Akbar. You have the tent of Abu Fadl. You have tents all over of the people of the Shuhada of Karbala, the family, the companions of Imam Al-Hussein. So inshallah we'll go around, get a few shots from all the different tents, and hopefully it will bring some new information to your eyes, and hopefully you can take some knowledge from what you see. So we are now standing outside the tent of Abi Abdullah Al-Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him, the master of martyrs. This is the central tent of the encampment. Around him, if you come around the back here, so this here in the middle is the tent of Imam Al-Hussein, the center tent. If you come around the back here, you have the tent of his son, Imam Al-Sajjad Zain Al-Abidin, peace and blessings be upon him. Around the other side, you have the tent here, the tent of Sayyida Zainab. So behind the tent of Imam Al-Hussein, which is there, you have the tent of Sayyida Zainab, between the tent of Imam Zain al-Abidin and Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. So let's go around and hopefully look at the rest of the tents here at the encampment. To sit with one of the servants of Imam Al-Hussein, and inshallah he will ask him some questions as to why he finds it important to pray in such a place like this and the importance of this place. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh. Shalom sahatkum.
Alhamdulillah. Barakat du'aakum. Allah
yafadak. Mulla, bas habbayt b'ra'ik na'raf shunu ahamiyat hadha al-mukan hasa qa'din bi, ahamiyat al-mukhayyam, wa laysh takhtaroon tsallun bi hadha al-mukan akthar min ghayr al-mukan.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. طبعا هذا المكان كرقعة جغرافية تاريخية لطالما عبد الله في هذا المكان الطاهر، ولطالما ذكرت الروايات أن لأهل البيت سلام الله عليهم في هذا المكان في أيام عاشوراء بالذات العشرة الأوائل من شهر محرم الحرام وقبل استشهاد الإمام الحسين، كان يسمع لأهل البيت دوي كدوي النحل في قراءة القرآن وإحياء الليل بالصلاة والتهجد والعبادة. فهذا المكان الطاهر هو مكان يعني إحنا نسميه بتسميتنا العامة هنا أهل كربلاء، نسميه بيت الحسين. هو خيام الحسين سلام الله عليه، وخيام أصحابه، وخيام أهل بيته. رقعة جغرافية جمعت أطهر الخلق في هذا المكان.
The reciter was saying that this place is geographically a very central place as to what happened during the Battle of Karbala, and this place housed the holy household of Imam al-Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. And this place is where the greatest night of Ibadah took place, and that is the night of Ashura. So he comes here, and many people do come here to remember the Ibadah that Sayyida Zainab and Imam Zain al-Abidin did. Abdullah, Sayyida Zainab, Imam Zain al-Abidin. This is the tent of the flag bearer and the backbone of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. This is the tent, this is the place of the tent of Abu Fadl al-Abbas, peace and blessings be upon him. And it is, as you can see, on the edge of the campsite, as he was the protector. He was there to hold the back of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein and make sure that no one gets close to his sister Sayyida Zainab. Now, important thing that I wanted to show as well is these lamps here. This setup is called a tekia. These lamps are called lalat. They are split on this side and on that side of the tents. Each lala, each lamp, represents a martyr of Karbala, whether it's family or companion. So each lala represents one. There are over, I think, 110 with the family of Imam Hussein, including the companions. Traditionally, they do 72. But I think the more accurate number is over 110. So they set in honor of those who were martyred during Karbala. This tekia here is all year. But everywhere else, they're setting it up and they do the up them from the 1st of Muharram until the day of Ashura, in which during the after the battle, they take it down, symbolizing the fall of the martyrs of Karbala. On the roof of the campsite of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, as you can see in the background, the green dome just there is the Tell Zainabi, the mount where Sayyida Zainab stood on while she watched Aba Abdullah during the battle. And as you can see, the dome of our master, the Imam Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. So if you take into account the distances from the campsite and where, how far Sayyida Zainab ran out to watch her brother in battle, as you can see, Abu Fadl is even further. So imagine how far down he went into the battlefield, deep into the enemy, to defend Aba Abdullah al-Hussein.